Hey guys, Bobby here, and today I thought I would bring you guys a commentary. I know you guys don't like commentaries for me that much, but frankly, I don't even like doing them. But today is a year since my uLoveCG channel has been going on, so I thought I would make a video. And I was gonna have Dangerous Toys come out today, but that didn't work out, so we're just gonna do a commentary. And I thought I would talk about, you know, how I got started with all this. I know you guys are like, alright, history, yeah! But it's gonna be fun. That's probably a lie, but we can try anyway. Alright. Did I already thank you guys? I can't remember. The whole point of this video is to thank you guys for being subscribed. So if I haven't already done, oh god, look at me. I'm falling apart a minute into the video. Look at that. A minute memory loss. That's terrible. If I haven't thanked you guys already, I would just like to thank you guys for being subscribed. You guys have been really great. Like, honestly, I have one of the best subscriber bases of my friends. You know what, this is gonna be one take. I'm not gonna fucking pause it. Usually when I do a commentary, like, it looks like I've just edited a montage with my audio. It's all chopped up bits and shit. But this time, it's one clean run, unedited. So, let's see how this works out. My first experience with, the whole Call of Duty YouTube thing was when, my friend Max came over to my house and he said, "Hey, Bobby, come check this guy Zergriz out on YouTube." And I was like, "Alright." I was the last one of my friends to get an Xbox, by the way. And my friend Max came over and says, "Hey, check out Zergriz. He has some cool videos about Call of Duty." And I've never actually seen any, like, gameplay videos before that. And so ever since Max showed me Zergriz's, like, a few of his videos, I've been watching like a few montages, like HQ Raiders montage that was on Machinima, and Dominators 2, Dominators also, and that's what made me want to do it. Those two montages, they made me want to, you know, start, you know, recording my own gameplay and making montages like that. And so I went out to my garage and I got my video camera. I set it up on a trash-picked CD stand or CD rack, and I recorded my gameplay. Like, I recorded like 10 games, just noskin' some guys from about 10 feet away or 7 feet away, and I brought them into Windows Movie Maker, and I edited my first montage, which, it was less than amazing. But, you know, a lot of people were actually doing this video camera to TV thing. And I didn't learn about Dazzle until my friend Austin or Laxman101 said, "Hey, Bobby, I'm getting a capture card." And I said, "What's that?" And he said, "Oh, it's how you record your gameplay, like, straight from your Xbox." I'm like, "Oh, that's pretty sick." And so I can't remember which one of us actually gets one first, but what made me want to get one, like, what made me want to, like, go out and spend money on the whole Call of Duty video making thing was, like, a lot of the no-scoping montages that already had, like, Dazzle quality, like, NSF Fate, his focus montage, which was is probably my favorite montage of all time. Just, like, it was so good for the time. I would personally rank it, like, number two most legendary montage of all time, like, underneath The Matrix. And so that, and also the dualtage with VGI Dynamite and Avage, and Operate Perry's dualtage with Valor. That's what made me, like, those few montages made me want to get a Dazzle. Operator Perry edited all those. Like, he was one of the only editors at the time. Like, a little time reference for you guys. Like, he had, like, 40 subscribers when I first found out about him. And then I sent him a friend request and they actually got through to him, and he accepted it, which would never happen today. And so he was, like, the first person that, like, was actually an already, like, a no-scope montage-making person. He was one of the first... I don't know how that fucking sounded. That probably sounded really messed up and bad, but he was one of the first people that was making montages that I had on my friends list. And another was NSF Gobay, and I actually got Fate on my montage, and that was a good day. The day I got Fate... Did I just say Fate on my montage? Whew, I am losing it. It is hot as balls in my room. I am sorry. But one take. Normally I would pause and go back. But I'm not doing that. Oh man, 5 minutes. I got like four left. Sweet. Anyway. The first thing I ever said to Fate when he joined one of my friend's sessions. I was friends with Cookie. Like, oh my god, I'm a cookie. He was friends with Fate, and Fate joined Cookie's session, and I was playing with him on Crossfire. My first words to Fate were, "Oh my god, Fate, you have the best montage on the internet." And those are my exact words. And he said, "Who said that?" I said, "Me." And so I sent him a friend request. He accepted it. And I was pretty stoked. You know, it was a good day. So, let's see, where do I go now? I guess, my first few videos were test videos, and my third video that I made with a Dazzle was, a Claymore montage. It was the second ever Claymore montage, and, you know, I thought it was pretty fun. I thought it would be fun to make a montage just to mess around, to have fun with the game, and, you know, using a passive, weapon like the Claymore. Then after that, my first actual montage was called Down and Out. And I remember the trailer was just like a back black. Oh my god. I'm gonna just have to sit down and watch TV and drink some water after this. After my first trailer was a back. Oh my god, I just messed up again. It was a black background, a video with a black background and black and white text. That was my trailer, and it said that my Down and Out montage was coming out, so everyone beware. And when that trailer, when I came out with my first Down and Out montage, I had about 200 subscribers, and I really put a lot of time into making this Down and Out montage, like recording for it. It was, all the gameplay was in sniper lobbies. Like, sniper lobbies weren't even questioned back then, because, you know, every single montage had sniper lobbies in it. Besides, like, the first two. And so, I spent a long time editing it too, and when I finally came out with it, Operator Perry sent me a message saying, "Hey, I like your montage, it deserves a lot more views, and I would like to put it on Top Notch." And so I said, "Yeah, that's awesome. Here's the file front." He put it up on Top Notch, it got a lot of views, and everyone really liked it. And that sent me from 200 subscribers to, like, 1,400 subscribers, I'd say. No, that's a lie, because I remember telling someone that it got me 700 subscribers, so it probably got me up to, like, almost 1K subscribers, like 900, maybe, over 900 I had by that time. And, then after that, I've been making videos, like, I've made the first Epic Wins, you know, it didn't have an intro sequence back then, it just said Epic Wins, and then it faded into, you know, the montage. And, you know, I made a few videos. One video that made me get, like, a lot of subscribers was the freakout video with where Mary Jane gets prestiged by his brother. And that's got me up to, like, 2,400 subscribers. You know, I skipped a lot of videos, but that was the last one I uploaded, was the freakout video. And then I got contacted by Halo Frontage. And then a few, like... They uploaded my video without permission, and so I filed a copyright complaint. We're friends now, but, I mean, back then, I filed a copyright complaint, and, you know, Activision really owns all the, like, legal rights to all Call of Duty videos, so they took down my, my YouTube channel, and that day I made this one, and I had a few of my other friends upload my sub video to get a few of my subscribers back. And I'm out of time, so You guys have been great. A huge percent of all of my video comments have been like really positive feedback. So thanks a lot. You guys are really great. I just like to say thanks, and Dangerous Toys will be out soon, so I'll see you later.